when you pray, or do you look up into that blue space? Take your choice, prayers flying from all directions. And don't worry about what language you use. God, no doubt, understands them all. Even when the swans are flying north and making such a ruckus of noise, God is surely listening and understanding. Rumi said, there is no proof of the soul. But isn't the return of spring and how it springs up in our hearts a pretty good hint? Yes, I know, God's silence never breaks. But is that really a problem? There are thousands of voices after all. And furthermore, don't you imagine, I just suggested, that the swans know about as much as we do about the whole business? So listen to them and watch them, singing as they fly. Take from it what you can.
In Emerson's essay on nature, his spiral balances nature and the soul. Philosophically considered, he writes, the universe is composed of nature and the soul. Strictly speaking, all that is separate from us, all which philosophy distinguishes as the not me, that is both nature and art and all other people and our own bodies, must be ranked under this name, nature. To speak truly, few adult persons can see nature. But in the wood is perpetual youth. Within these plantations of God, a decorum and sanctity reign. A perennial festival is dressed, and the guest sees not how we should tire of them in 1,000 years. In the woods, we return to reason and faith. There, I feel that nothing can befall me in life. No disgrace, no calamity, leaving my eyes, which nature cannot repair. Standing on the bare ground, my head bathed by the blithe air, and uplifted into infinite space, all mean egotism vanishes. I become a transparent eyeball. I am nothing. I see all. The currents of the universal being circulate through me. I am part or particle of God. Commentary. Because we can see and can analyze what we see, we are capable of developing our understanding. This understanding of ours expands when we carefully observe nature, art, other people, even our own bodies. There is a mystery to it all. Emerson says that everything that is not me, which really means not our soul, is to be considered a part of nature. But in this loop on Emerson's spiral, he also says there is something so majestic about the natural world that our eyeballs become silent witnesses, as if they are fused with our souls. We not only observe the beauty that surrounds us, we can see. We can also feel in our souls the otherworldly majesty of the natural world. His words, nature is awesome. This recognition of this miraculous world, of our miraculous world, serves as an entry into that of God within. What I see Emerson saying here is that our consciousness connects us with our soul. And Emerson's ideas on nature have led us, as Unitarian Universalists, to a deep, deeper, and deepening appreciation of the inner voice. Let us enter a moment of silence, reflection, meditation, or prayer.